Welcome to Holy Cross, all new students, especially in grade 9 and 10. We are so happy to have you here in person with us this year. Even though the past couple of years have been challenging for all of us, we know we are a strong community here at HCC, and that strength helps us persevere. Please get involved and connected. We want you to feel at home. Ask questions and contribute ideas. Together, we are all stronger. Each of us is a unique piece of a large puzzle here at HCC, and we know how frustrating it is when we work on a puzzle and there's a piece or two missing. So it's really important that we all feel connected and purposeful in our daily activities here at the school. Good luck this year and all the best.
Welcome grades 9 and grade 10. My name is Natalie Haliba and I'm your chaplaincy leader here at Holy Cross. I look forward to getting to know you more over the next few years through school liturgies, class retreats, daily prayer, and chaplaincy team. My door is always open to you if you need someone to talk to. Holy Cross is home of the centurions. So what is a centurion? A centurion was a Roman soldier in the army, and they were responsible to lead 100 soldiers at a time. Another term for 100 soldiers was a century, hence the term centurion. As centurions of Holy Cross, we too are called to be leaders. We are responsible for leading others to Jesus. In the Gospel of Luke, we hear about a story of a centurion who brings his servant who is sick to Jesus. This servant was of great value to the centurion, and so he wanted the very best for him. So what did he do? He brought his sick servant to Jesus. In Luke chapter 7, we read, "When Jesus was not far from the house, the centurion sent friends to him, saying, 'Lord, do not trouble yourself, for I am not worthy to have you come under my roof. Therefore, I do not presume to come to you, but say the word, and my servant shall be healed.' When Jesus heard these things, he marveled at him, and turning to the crowd that followed him, said, 'I tell you, not even in Israel have I found such faith.' And when those who had been sent returned to the house, they found the servant well." As centurions, we are called to be people of faith, to believe in Jesus, to bring others to Jesus, to have faith that anything is possible in Jesus. This is good news. This is what the gospel is all about. In the year ahead, I encourage you to bring others to Jesus through what you say and through what you do. Let us pray. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Lord Jesus, we ask for your blessing upon our whole school, and in a special way our grade 9s and grade 10s. Give them the courage and strength to be faith leaders in our school, our families, and in the wider community. Help us to lead others closer to you. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
We'll be right back. I can only imagine.
Okay, the Bible verse you will be looking for today is Psalm chapter 133, verse 1.
What my eyes will see when your face is before me, I can only imagine. Surrounded by your glory, what will my heart feel? Will I dance for?
So the riddle you guys are going to have to find today is, what room has the most words in it?
Staring at the lights, they look so pretty. Mama said, son, 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 son.
Come on,
to the library.
Run, run, run. Run, run, run. Run, run, run. When I was a young kid living in the city, all I did was pay, 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 pay.
You got it, guys. You guys got here first.
Okay.
You guys win.
Meet up, but living down low. Chasing that luck before I get old. Looking back, oh, we had some fun.
3, 2, 1, go.
That the sky might fall. They'll say that you might lose it all. So I'll run until I hit that wall. Yeah, I learned my lesson. Count my blessings up to the rising sun. Run, run, run. Yeah, one day will the sky might fall. Yeah, one day I could lose it all. So I'll run. See that light in the morning shining down on me.
So the first question we have is an English question. What is the noun in this sentence? It was a boring, cool September day. I woke up to the colorful smell of toucan burning.
Yes, well, there's several, but day What's the first noun?
So I guess my question is,
grade 10!
I guess you win. So that one, okay. The next question is a math question.
So we're
doing addition. So what is 56 plus 17?
73?
Yes. Correct.
Good one.
So the next one is a religion question. What is the first book in the Bible?
Genesis?
Yeah.
I knew that one too. That's not fair.
Next we have a science question. What is the element P, capital P, B?
P, B.
Yeah.
Plume. Which is lead?
Yeah. Okay, last one.
I didn't think about it in French.
Okay, the last one is a music question.
Oh boy.
How many beats are in a quarter note?
Four?
Oh wait. 25! That's way too many.
Yeah. Well, a quarter, 25 cents?
No.
Eight. Two. No.
How many beats in a quarter note?
Quarter note.
One?
A quarter.
One.
Three, two, one, go. Mr. Ayres, you won this round.
Woo!
Bob and MJP, you're grade 10s. They won overall.
Yeah!